Well, back in the 1860s, during the Victorian era, we thought it was evil for boys and girls to touch themselves, so society thought that the solution would be is to remove the foreskin on the boys in order to deaden their penis and put carbolic acid on the clitoris of little girls.
Huh.
When you remove the foreskin, you remove what is called the ridged band of sexual nerves, the most highly concentrated set of nerves in the male's anatomy, sexual nerves.
Uh-huh.
When you remove the foreskin, you sever the frenulum, and the frenulum connects to the brain and to the ridge band of sexual nerves inside the foreskin. So when you remove the sender, the brain is not getting the pleasure signals anymore.
Huh.
And thus, you're deprived of the actual intercourse and masturbation pleasure, sexual pleasure. Guys that are cut, they never experience sex in color. It's all black and white for them.
Uh-huh.
The intact male, on the other hand, when he masturbates and drags his foreskin up over the head of the gland, he's massaging that ridge band of sexual nerves, which is giving him pleasure. But when he's having sex, the same thing occurs. When the foreskin rolls up over the head of the gland, he gets his pleasure. But because of the double fold layer of skin, it causes the penis to get thicker, which provides more stimulation to the root of the female's clitoris, which gives her a deeper vaginal orgasm.
Uh-huh.
I had a German rocket scientist here about 4 years ago. He heard I was from Cocoa Beach.
Yeah.
And he says, you know what I find so fascinating in your country is that everywhere you go, there's sexual lubricants. He says, in my country, that's not the case. It's a novelty. You got to go to a special shop to get it. Well, what happens when a cut male has sex with a female? Every time he retracts, it's dragging vaginal fluids out because of that backward head of a plunger that we got.
Uh-huh.
And I don't care how good a man thinks he is, he will eventually dry her out, create friction, and create pain.
Yeah.
But with the intact male, she grips the foreskin, it works as a plug, keeps most of vaginal fluids inside, and when he retracts, he's not rubbing her vaginal walls, he's sliding on the inside of the foreskin.
Huh.
And which will gives him much more pleasure and her pleasure.
Yeah.
You know, we have destroyed the natural act of sex in this country. And if you take a look at who are the most violent people in the world, it's pretty simple. It's your genital mutilators.
Huh.
Your Jews cut, your Muslims cut, and your Americans cut. We're over there in the Middle East right now killing each other. And I can't blame it all on the foreskin, but, you know, who else is fighting in this big-ass war? Nobody else.
It's good. That's, I never heard that perspective on it. So, and would you want to comment on the potential health risks of not being circumcised?
There is no real big health problem because most of the men in the world are not circumcised. They're intact.
Mm-hmm.
It's only here in this country that we have blamed everything from tuberculosis to clubfoot to bedwetting, the rapist, we blame it all on the foreskin. And the latest thing now is HIV.
Yeah.
We're over in Africa wanting to circumcise every male over there. Bill Gates, he's donated $50 million. We think that's going to stem the spread of HIV. Well, 28 years ago, when the first case of HIV was diagnosed here in America, 90-some plus percent of our sexually active males were circumcised. It did not stop nor slow the spread of HIV.
Yeah.
Safe sex, condoms, and leaving the whores alone.
Uh-huh.
You know, they could go and cut all the males in the world, but if you keep having risky sex, you're going to get something, you know?
Right.
And why do we have to circumcise everybody? Because one individual is going to be a whore.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
You're supposed to
grow up, find your woman, and that's your mate for life.
Yeah.
You wouldn't have to worry about no diseases.
Yeah.
You know, we, off of one infant's foreskin, it's a $1 billion industry. Off of one infant's foreskin, you can grow 6 football fields of skin at $3,000 in 11 square inch patch. Oprah rants and raves about a facial cream she uses, and she goes, oh, it's great, and the best thing about it, it's made off out of discarded foreskins. Well, they're not discarded, they're stolen.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
Yet she speaks out against female circumcision,
right.
And yet she thinks it's okay to cut up our males. And if you believe in the U.S. Constitution, We passed a law back March 30th, 1996, that outlawed female genital cutting in this country because we were afraid radical Muslims were going to immigrate and want to practice what they've done for thousands of years. Well, according to the 14th Amendment, Congress shall pass no laws that are sexually discriminatory. So if you're going to protect the girls, you need to protect the boys.
Uh-huh.
And the biggest one is freedom of religion. You got to watch that one, because we're all immigrants. We all came here from somewhere else. So the Jews brought circumcision for religious reasons. Muslims got male circumcision for religious reasons. Well, now we're trying to say that the radical Muslims that are immigrating to our country can't practice their religious beliefs. And
yeah.
Not all Muslims cut their girls, but...
You mean that you said the Muslims brought male circumcision, but you mean brought female circumcision,
well,
right?
No, or male? We allow male circumcision in this country for
right.
religious reasons
yeah,
and
that's
for
right.
cosmetic
yeah,
reasons.
That's right. That's
well,
right.
If we're going to allow religious male circumcision
yeah.
under our Constitution,
right.
what happens with the radical Muslims that are immigrating to our country that want to cut their girls?
Right.
Oh,
right.
You can't do that. We don't like that here.
Yeah.
Well,
yeah.
The Constitution says you have a freedom of religion.
Yeah.
And if you believe that's your religious right, mark my words, they'll be challenged within the U.S. Supreme Court eventually.
Okay. Because
there are men that are in prison right now, Muslims, that have cut their daughters.
Yeah.
And we put them in jail for that.
Right.
But yet we think it's perfectly okay to strap a boy to a board and rip him apart. And the other thing that the medical community won't tell you, over 200 boys die every year in this country because of circumcision. But they don't list the cause of death as circumcision. They list it as hemorrhage or infection. Well, how did the boy bleed to death?
Yeah,
you cut
really.
The end of his penis off. And how did he get an infection? You cut his penis up and he caught MRSA or got sepsis. Or, you know,
yeah, yeah.
It's mind-blowing. It really is.
So do you think it should be illegal?
It should be illegal up until the age of 18 at the age of consent.
Okay.
Once an adult male figures out, well, I don't want this anymore, he can go and do whatever he wants.
Right.
But as an infant, you should not force your will on me, especially a sexually crippling surgery like this.
Yeah.
And we have people from all over the world come here and talk to us, and they are appalled that we are cutting our boys. We are the only Western civilization, and I use that loosely, that cuts their boys.
Yeah.
You go around into Europe, well, when you hear about yeah. European lover, Latin lover, Caribbean lover, they're hanging. They still got
yeah.
their anatomy there.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, it's
right.
the American male that can't perform properly and please his woman, the circumcised
yeah.
woman.
Right.
You know?
Right. Interesting.
Yeah.
Well, and so people want to find out more about it, they should go to stopinfantcircumcision.org.
Okay. We are the sixth society, the
Great.
Stop Infant Circumcision Society.
Well,
and
good.
I've been coming here for 17 years.
Okay.
I learned about this insanity at the age of 11. I'm 56 now. My mom's from the Bahamas, and you'd think she would have known better, but she married a Navy guy. And the second day of my life in Tripler Army Hospital in Honolulu, I was torn apart.
Yeah.
But it's still going on today, and it shouldn't. Every
okay.
26 seconds, a boy is strapped to a board, and he has his genitals torn apart. It's crazy.
Thanks for the information. Do you want to share your name?
David Wilson.
Okay, good
Some
to meet you.
Some people call me David M.F. Wilson, but...
yeah, well, whatever. Whatever they call you, as long as they call
All
you
right.
for dinner.
And go to
okay.
the website.
Yeah, thank you. I appreciate
All
the
right,
information.
Thank you.
Yep, bye-bye.